memories of yesterday. I remember Papa before his hair started turning gray. He'd come in from the fields tired and worn completely out, but he didn't know what giving up was all about. Even in the hard times, we held on to our dreams of something more than cotton fields and secondhand blue jeans. But then one night, my papa died and left those dreams to me. And Lord, somehow you made life.
Lord be with you.
With faith
in Jesus, we receive the body of our brother Rudy for burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, remember before you this day our brother Rudy. We thank you for giving him to us as family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Either right.
passion never fades. Every morning, we are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither life, neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. Nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The hymn through all the changing scenes of life.
Thank you.
scripture is taken from Isaiah 25:6-9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of fat things, a feast of wine on the lees, of fat things full of marrow, of wine on the lees will be well refined. And he will destroy on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces. And the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken.
Word of the Lord. The word of the Lord. Just say the word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord.
The scripture reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 50-58. I declare you, brothers and sisters, that the flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed in a flash, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For the perishable must clothe itself with imperishable, and the mortal with immortality. When the perishable is being clothed with the imperishable, and the mortal with immortality, then the saying that is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm, let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Parents, scripture reading.
Thanks be to God. We stand and sing the hymn, "The Lord's My Shepherd," 478 in the Blue Box.
Thank you.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John, the 14th chapter, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to Christ, our Savior.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
Good morning, Church.
Good morning.
This morning, my task is to express on behalf of 40, 50 of us, as ushers here at St. Agnes, condolences. I want to take the liberty to do the same on behalf of the Anglican Church men and the men at large in St. Agnes, because Rudy was a man. He was a man. He represented men well. Rudy had a love for family, for church, for friends, and for politics. And I believe it was in that order. But here at St. Agnes, Rudy had become a leader to us, a mentor in the usher board. And as grown as we are, he was our disciplinarian. He was a philanthropist at heart, and celebrated, and he was delightfully a military man, because everything he did reflected his training as a police officer, even directing us. He instilled that. I want to say that we have grown to love, to appreciate, and to respect Rudy. He took over from Mr. Toppin a few years ago, and he did us proud. Without a doubt, Rudy knew every church season, every church hymn, every church color occasion. He kept abreast of it. Rudy, as our leader, was always prompt, never late, 1 or 1.5 hours before any service, any occasion he has to be here, he was here. And when we step out of line, you could see him run up the aisle or throw
throw his hand up on. Okay? That was Rudy's style. Rudy had a love for his Cat Island. And he invited us, as many of us who wanted to go, to come with him. I went on two or three occasions. I promised never to go again because all he wanted me to do is drink Vitamalt, water, and soda. I couldn't drink nothing else. And every stop they made, you know what happened. Rudy loved his church. Rudy was our guardsman at the back. And anytime Rudy was here and anything went out of order, Rudy was militant about it. And when Rudy stood, we all knew that we had to stand because no one was allowed to come into our church and get out of hand. We would have had to physically take the person out. I want to say to the family that he loved all of you dearly, particularly them grand boys. He was crazy over them grand boys. I had an occasion to do some work in Abaco, and he got to find out. And he called me on two occasions. He had a grandson working there. He said, give him some money. When you come, I can pay you. Give him some money when I come. And the guy was working, but Rudy made sure he had that extra, never to be concerned. The pandemic threw him off because we all knew Rudy as a businessman, but that pandemic put a dent in him, discouraged him. And then it took a little while before the club was reopened and Rudell took over. But when someone could manage to process a business for as long as he did, it means that he knew what he was doing. And for some of us here at St. Agnes, he was that leader, he was that mentor. I've been in business for 36 years, and oftentimes we had exchanges. The Prime Minister's here, my friend Fred Mitchell is here, and he was crazy over them too. Anything went wrong, that you talk to Fred? What do you say? Rudy's place was the center of information. Church for Rudy was important, and Rudy knew the changes that were to occur in church before some of the priests knew. And I was his friend. I had become, I don't know how, why, when, but I had become his friend. And he and I, every week, had discussions on what's going on in church. And so it's not easy for us, as members of the usher board, to say to our friend, our leader extraordinaire, farewell. But we have to. And so on behalf of all of us, I say to the family, be encouraged. We believe that Rudy's long time sickness, that the Lord was preparing us to say goodbye because it was not instant. We want to express our condolences to each of you and say to you that the God whom we serve knows best. And we pray that he will comfort each of you over these next few weeks and months and years to come. May he rest in peace.
Amen. And now a tribute by Reserve Superintendent Douglas Hanna.
I have been asked by the commissioner, Mr. Clayton Fernanda, to first of all give apologies for his absence. He really, really wanted to be here. Mr. Stubbs, you know Mr. Stubbs, in the early days, we knew Dolly. But he has some prior engagement that he could not attend. So I will speak on behalf of the Commissioner and of Mr. Rudy Stubbs' tenure in the Royal Bahamas Police Force. Rudy joined the police force in October 13, 1965. Well, we all come in as recruit constable, and he was assigned that number 576. Upon completion of his training, he was first posted at the Central Division. And then he also worked at Traffic Division, Criminal Investigation Department, Grand Bahama, the Police College, and Great Harbor Key. Now, from the very beginning of Constable 576 tenure, he exhibited two things very quickly: devotion to the mandate of the Royal Bahamas Police Force, and then he attracted the attention of so many persons in the Royal Bahamas Police Force at that time, his high level of intelligence. He exhibited this intelligence, and eventually he went to the Criminal Investigation Department as a detective. Now, because of his astuteness and his capacity for investigation, he was eventually assigned to further his career in many areas locally and abroad. Rudy actually trained at the FBI Academy Training School at that time. He trained at the Drug Enforcement Training School in Washington, D.C. At that time, and many other development courses locally and abroad. He also got a training that was sponsored at the U.S. Navy Criminal Investigation Department. And so the need was seen for Rudy to really sharpen the natural skills that he had. Rudy served with distinction. Rudy was known, I think it was said a couple of minutes ago, as a disciplinarian. And I'll get a little personal now with the tenure of Rudy, in particular in the Criminal Investigation Department. Rudy was a teacher. Some of the former officers there can talk about it. He was a teacher. Officers who started an investigation, and Rudy looked and said, "What garbage are you doing here, officer?" And he quickly said, "You're right." One of the things that Rudy was noted for, and some of the officers mentioned it, he had a handwriting. He had to be a skilled, he must have born to be a skilled writer, because he had a handwriting out of this world. Sometimes in life, let's say in the Royal Bahamas Police Force, you develop characteristics that can help you throughout the Royal Bahamas Police Force. I didn't think about this until many years later. I think I would have had about 3 months in the Criminal Investigation Department at that time, or maybe a little more. And Rudy came to me one night, and I talked this little secret now, that when things were not as hectic as they were now on the streets and other way. But so usually when things got really quiet, we had a small crew in CID who used to like play whist. And so because I came from the street, they thought I could play whist, and I did start. So one day Rudy and Guy Johnson came to me and said, "No playing whist tonight." Said, "Let's go and we'll take you. I'm going to show you." Rudy said to me, "I hear you say you from East Street. I'm going to show you about East Street." Obviously, at that time, I did not know he actually almost grew up on East Street. And so we went on. Rudy said, "We're going to show you the good, the bad, and the ugly." And so we went out and we started and said, we're going to ensure the streets are calm, that the bad guys go home, so that citizens can sleep, and so that your team members up there could play whist. And we went And first we check all of the known streets where persons were, and Rudy with his kindness and Guy Johnson with his politeness. And we went to all the streets. And we made sure, came out of the car, everybody saw us around, and those went home. Around 3 o'clock in the morning, says, that is the good. And then we move around a little bit, check some neighborhoods. Let me say, that is the good also. So I wanted to know when was the bad. He said, no bad tonight, but I'm going to show you a little bit ugly. And so we went and we check some little libation spots. And we went in all of those. Checked them, made sure everything was quiet. I don't know if we got any libations, God. But the lesson I learned and they taught me was, folks, you hear about community policing and all of this schooling, all of this community policing. Garth and Rudy taught me the real community policing that night. And I didn't realize that until later on, and if anybody know me, that is what I did in my career later on. I'm out and I made sure the streets are quiet, make sure citizens could behave, could sleep in peace. And that is the lesson that I learned that night. One other encounter that I think served me well with Rudy, I think in Rudy's latter years, one night, I don't know, in the middle of the night, the command of the Royal Boundary got some information about something that was supposed to go down in Great Abiquiu. And so they look around and they found, I think, myself and Melvin Lundy. And so I think it was dark, and they picked us up, carrying us a plane, and dropped us on Great Abiquiu, and says, something may happen. And then if nothing happened, then you have to go and get some inquiries at that time. Rudy was an officer in charge down there. So we spent the night at the airport. Nothing happened. And then I was in the dilemma because now I had to go and find what's going on. So when they say, oh, I'm going looking for Rudy. And when found him, the officer in charge, and he looked at me, Mr. Dougie, where you come from? You drop out the sky? How you get here? I said, I'm here. And I said, but we need this information. We say, see you later. Don't come. Get away. So I went, and I said, go on. He said, you really going? I said, you send me. And he came behind me and said, listen, this is the mission. And we worked. Although he was angry that, wow, you all came here. I was not aware about it. But, you know, that's, we all know police officers know that is the nature of how things is. The less person know about any operation no more. But again, that taught me a lesson. Not like now, a lot of persons keep the little gripe and interferes with doing your job. And by time we were finished that night, although whatever happened had happened prior, but we got all the information enough for an investigation to pursue. Rudy was a soldier. He has left his mark. Officer number 576, and you can be proud of his tenure in the Royal Bahamas Police Force. Sleep on, Rudy. God will continue to bless your family and your presence. Thank you very much.
And now a selection by Mr. Patrick Lightman.
Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise. But it was grace that bought my liberty. I do not know just how he came to love me so. He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs. I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary to view the cross where Jesus died for me. How marvelous the grace that bought my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my need. If not for grace, my soul would be a drifting ship with no safe harbor from the stormy waves. But Calvary's cross shined brightly through the darkest storm, and just in time His mercy rescue me. I shall forever lift mine eyes to Calvary to view the cross where Jesus died for me. How marvelous the grace that bought my fallen soul. He looked beyond my faults and saw my needs. He looked beyond falls and so
seated. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen. The 58th verse of the 15th chapter of St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. Be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord. Today I am here to bring this sermon on behalf of my good buddy, Archdeacon Ranfley Brown, who is here with us today. And of course, he has not been altogether well. But we want to let him know that we love him and we are praying for his full recovery. I bring you greetings and condolences on behalf of our Lord Bishop, Bishop Leish Boyd, and Archbishop Drexel Gomez, who called this morning to let us know that he is not able to come, but wanted his condolences brought. And Father James Moultrie, who is traveling to get his next treatment here at the Cleveland Clinic. We want to pray for his full recovery as well. And of course, my own dear friend Archdeacon and Canon Stephen Davies, the chaplain of His Majesty's Royal Bahamas Police Force, and my dear brother in crime, Canon Sebastian Kiara Island Campbell. We go way back from St. Johnstown. My dear brother, Father Andrew Toppin, who is here. My brother, Father Rodney Burrows and Father Neil Nen. And my dear brother, Berkeley Smith. And of course, Father Travis Fernandez doing the Mass today along with Deacon Bethel. But we are delighted to have the president of our Bahamas Christian Council, the Reverend Dr. Delton Fernanda. And of course, I want to welcome to St. Agnes again our dear Prime Minister, the Honorable Philip Brave Davis, who is a wonderful, wonderful vestry member, synodsman, and faithful member of our church. We're delighted to have him with us today. And of course, the Honorable Fred Mitchell, who was here but had to leave, and the Honorable Keith Bell, and my wonderful, wonderful lay reader, the Honorable Bacchus Roll. All of us are here. Of course, Her Excellency Dame Marguerite Pinlin is in her seat in the guard room. And of course, we are delighted to have all of you here today. This is an honor to speak the truth. It's an honor to be able to say these few words on behalf of my dear friend Rudy. Like I said, Archdeacon Brown is supposed to have done this sermon today because he helped to grow him up. And he told me that long time. And so, Brown, I hope I make you proud today, this Conky Joe, your bold boy. But God is good. And you know, when we speak about the words of St. Paul, St. Paul was writing to those sailormen, those military men in Corinth. And Corinth was a rough, rough seaport. And Paul had to write to let them know just how things go. And in doing so, he spoke plainly about death. And if you read the letter, Paul makes faces, as we would say in Codrington College, at the enemy. He says, the thing that we fear the most is death. And yes, he says, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? He makes fun out of it. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through Jesus Christ. That's the thing. And so he goes on to explain further and tells us just how we are to attain this wonderful victory. And he tells us, you guys be steadfast, immovable, and always abounding in the work of the Lord. Friends, that is the key. Be faithful. You hear me? Be faithful. Steadfastness. We can't be good all the time. Let's be real. We make mistakes. We do wrong. We go astray. But for Lord's sake, be faithful. Be faithful. Steadfastness. Try your best to be faithful. And today I want to say unequivocally that Rudy was faithful. Now, you ain't gotta go left nor right. The man was faithful to a T and on time. Not like Father Cartwright. On time. And so, yes, we celebrate a faithful soldier in this church who cared and loved his church to the depths of his heart. And he demonstrated that every single opportunity, not only on Sundays, you know, but as best he could, despite all the activities that he was involved in. He was faithful in this church. And not only faithful, but supportive of this church. Every single time since the news came, he said he wasn't well. When he came back from Cat Island, he called me. He said, "Father, I ain't feeling good." I say, "What?" He said, "No, I got to go to the doctor." And he finished going to the doctor. He called me back. But never a time, never a Sunday went by. And once he was not able to come, Rudy would call and say, "Please excuse me. But I can tell you before I hit the office, Rudy's tithes were there." And when I go to visit, I say, "Rudy, it's time for us to be doing something for you." He say, "No, sir. I made my provisions and my preparations for any eventuality. That is my duty to my God." And I say, "No, man, Rudy." He say, "Father, you hear what I say? Faithfulness." Thanksgiving came. He said to me, "Listen, my envelope is there. I want you to do what you're supposed to do with that for the poor." He was faithful. And so, friends, let me say something to all of us today. We need to remember whose we are and what we are. And remember that there's a God who created us in his image and likeness, and we ought to be faithful to him. And stop this slackness that we have gotten ourselves used to, particularly after the COVID, where we want to stay home to suck up the video. Bring your behind to church. Plain speaking, be faithful to the God you know and love. Come to his church. Be faithful and stop all the excuses. Yes, some of us, as I said, all of us, we make mistakes. No one could point any finger at nobody else. You remember whose you are. Be faithful. And that is what he was, not only in his church, but also in his role in the community as a police officer and as a businessman. Impeccable, always making sure that everything was just right. He was an organized man. That's the second thing. A born leader. Organized man in his steadfastness, organization. There was no confusion when it came to his work. He had every I dotted and every T crossed. In his ministries in this church, he led with distinction. and he made sure that things were done on time. He had little patience for slackness. Little patience. And yes, sometimes when you rubbed him the wrong way, well, you got a few choice words. But you knew where you stood with him. And you didn't have to hear it behind your back. He told you to your teeth. This is how I feel. And that was that. And so today, his steadfastness. But then he was immovable. Immovable. And when we talk about immovable, you didn't have to worry about it. Rudy had his position, and he stood his ground. He didn't take no nonsense. He was a true member of the church. And when this one flipped this place, and flipped that place, and go around this corner here, that wasn't Rudy. Rudy knew where he belonged, and you couldn't get that out of him. Straight up, immovable, he stood his ground. Not only in the church, but in the PLP as well. Huh? Huh? What are you saying that for? I speak in the truth in love. He stood his ground. And talk about Cat Island. Cat Island has lost a true son of the soil, a nation builder. He loved his Cat Island. And every time we talk, I will say, well, you know, Cat Island is cousin to Long Island because we look alike. I say, you know, the sweetest rake and scrape is from Long Island. He said, oh, no, Father, that's Cat Island. I say, boy, well, we can dance tonight. But faithful to Cat Island, eh? More Cat Islanders need to take a page out of Rudy's book. Dumfries, oh, yes. Cat Island, my friend. And so be proud of where you come from. Be proud of your island. And yes, he did his best for his home. And I salute him today, because more of us need to remember where we come from. So many of us have come from the islands, and we go to come to Nassau and get big shot and everything else and forget your ma, who's still living in the clapboard house on the island, and he ain't even sending nothing on the mailboat, looking for your ma to send you doggone it box. That's how it goes. Many of us don't know the last time we did anything for home. And this country has been built on the backs of family islanders. Never forget them. Never forget where you come from. But some of us put on airs. Beautiful, this Bahamas. Rudy was an immovable Cat Islander. And he was strong for his Cat Island. And I salute him today. But not only that, immovable on that police force. Now, you couldn't go through Rudy, brother. That man was strict. Did not take fools like strict. But we don't like strictness, you know. We like slackness. That's the trouble. But you wasn't going to be slack around Rudy. You go on the police force, Rudy was a straight A. That's it. Come across the line, you're in trouble. Even his ma knew that. He'd lock her up. Because right was right and wrong was wrong. And he didn't see no gray. And that is the kind of police officers we need today. So when they flag me down, Father, I said, I wrong. Give him a ticket. Let me just put on the sign. I wrong. I'll go pay him a ticket. Right is right and wrong is wrong. And Rudy made sure that he kept that discipline. Immovable. He wasn't going to be shady here or there. No, right is right and wrong is wrong. And we in the Bahamas, we like to go round about the way and under the table and slip this here and slip this here. All of us like to do it. But it's wrong. It's wrong. If I got to go to the government office or any office for that matter, because we do it in the private sector too. Man, I'm a little hungry, you know. I need a lunch. You're working. Why I got to give you $20 to give me what you're supposed to be working to do? Your belly hungry, mine hungry too. Do your job and stop looking for something for nothing. Do what you're supposed to do with integrity and honor for the best of our country. And that is what we have to do. You know, when they come and they say, well, Father, this, I say, no, I don't need, that's my responsibility. That's what I'm here for. You don't have to pay me for that. People come and say, well, your funeral, pay for what? This is what I'm here for. You want to pay the baptist for what? This is what I'm here for. You want to do something? Do something for the church. I don't need nothing. I need Jesus. We need to remember that we ought not to be doing these things. Give God the glory and serve Him. Be immovable. And let us get back to the basics. And that is why we get so much trouble in the government today. Because of us not wanting to do what we're supposed to do without looking for something different. Do what you're supposed to do and do it for the honor and glory of God. And yes, always abounding in the work of the Lord. You see, only what you do for God can last you though. That's what we got to remember. At the end of the day, serve the Lord. Do His work. Remember whose you are. The day before Rudy died, he called me. And he said to me, he said, well, Father, this is the best I've ever felt since the sickness. We talked about the Lord. We talked about Cat Island. We talked about the church. You name it. But at the end of the day, I said, well, anyhow, Rudy, I'm coming down to bring you communion tomorrow. He said, no, 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 no. He said, Father, you got Sunday coming up here, this then Thursday. You straight. I could be here for your money. Don't. I said, no, I'm coming tomorrow to see you. No, 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 no. I straight, Father. I good. I good with the Lord. I still had to come the next day to close his eyes. But you see, that's what I'm trying to say to us. Be steadfast. Be immovable. And always abounding in the work of the Lord. That's the key. That's the key. So we could look at Mr. Death and say, where you going, Bala? We got you. Because we got the victory in Jesus Christ. The victory. And it's because we have been faithful. Because we have been immovable. And because we always work for the Lord. My brother Rudy, boy, the Lord love you best. God bless you. And we'll see you on the other side. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And now let's stand as we boldly confess what we believe in as Christians. In the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Father.
For our brother Rudy, let us pray to the Lord Christ, who said, I am resurrection and I am life. Lord, you consoled Mary and Martha in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Rudy and dry the tears of those who weep. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. You raised the dead to life. Raise our brother Rudy to eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother Rudy to the joys of heaven. Our brother Rudy was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our brother Rudy. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope.
Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother Rudy, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that his death may recall to us the victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in the Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow you where you have led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. My brothers and sisters in Christ, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, the truth is not in us. However, if we confess our sins, God, he is faithful, he is just, and he will forgive each and every one of us of our sins. In a moment of silence, reverently kneeling as you are able, let us draw to mind all the wrong that we have committed against Almighty God as we prepare to confess. Together, let us confess our sin. Almighty God, my heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and one another in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are sorry to repent for all our sins. For your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May Almighty God have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins,
upright and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of life eternal. For to your faithful people, all life, Lord, life is changed, not ending. And when our mortal bodies lie in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore we praise you, joining our voice with the angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Sovereign Lord and Father, to you be glory and praise forever. In your boundless wisdom, you brought creation into being. In your great love, you fashioned us in your image. In your tender compassion, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, to share our human nature. In the power of the Holy Spirit, he overcame the power of sin and death and brought your people to new birth as first fruits of your new creation. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to the command of your dearly beloved Son, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer you, Father, our sacrifice of thanks and praise. Send your Holy Spirit on these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord and Redeemer, Jesus Christ. As we partake of this holy food of new and unending life, may your Holy Spirit establish us as a royal priesthood with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Baptist, St. Agnes, and all your sons and daughters who share in your eternal inheritance through Jesus Christ, our Lord. With him, and in him, and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise.
Savior has taught us, so we pray. This bread to share in the body of Christ. My brothers and sisters in Christ, the gifts of God for the people of God. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant him rest. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant him rest. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant him rest eternal. Thank you. us give Almighty God thanks for taking part in this His body and blood, using our post-communion prayer found in your funeral booklets. Together we say, Almighty God, we thank you for your great love. You have fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that his sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Mass has ended. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace. Amen.
A solo by Mr. Harold Dawson.
Best for you. mistaken. God is too good to be unkind. So when you don't understand, when you don't see his plan, when you can't trace his hand, trust his heart. So when you don't understand, when you don't see his plan, when you can't trace God's hand, trust his heart. Trust his heart.
Please stand, including the family. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant Rudy with your saints together, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind. We are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us commend our brother Rudy to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Rudy, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Rudy. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and in the glorious company of the saints in light, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
His soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. Amen.
risen from the dead, crowned now death by death, and given life to those who are in the tomb. Son of righteousness is gloriously risen, given life to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. Lord, will guide our feet in the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Lord, now let thy servant depart in peace, to thy word. For mine eyes had seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared in the presence of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles, and the glory of your people Israel. May the angels lead thee into paradise. May the martyrs receive thee at thy coming, and bring thee in the city, Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels receive thee. Mayest thou with Lazarus once more have everlasting rest.
Thank you. Nobody! All right! Whoa! Oh.
Thank you for the many good things that you have accomplished through the dedicated and unselfish service of this departed retired officer. We praise you for building your kingdom here on earth by the service you rendered. Look now on him in your love and rescue him from the power of eternal darkness. And now, Father, that his tour of duty has ended, bring him into the joy and peace of your kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gracious Father, Father of mercy, love, and all comfort, we pray you console and comfort the colleagues of this departed retired officer, that casting their grief on you, they may know the power of your love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Honors, I'll die.
Thank you. again. Thank you. Attention! On parade, dismiss.
Of a woman hath but a short time to live. Like a flower he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow he flees and never stays. In the midst of life we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
Short and certain hope. Of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commit this, our brother, to earth. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust.
And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love, to die in your favor. When your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, this our brother Rudy and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
home the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity. We give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who have been finished their race, their course in faith. Now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life, resurrection, righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your very beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come you, O blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer.
Amen.
Amen.
God, O Lord, to all who are believed, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to be prepared to come.
And the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May Rudy's soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, the mercies of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
God bless you, Rudy, and keep you. The Lord, with his mercy and favor, look upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. The hymn, Abide With Me.
Abide with me. Change and decay, hear all around.
Missionary.